Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Harlequin Coho Invitational Tournament Grand Finals. This is game two in a best of five between AFK Ninja and ProPipe. And since it is the second game, they have both swapped factions, and ProPipe, being the loser of the first game, has been able to choose this map. So let's go ahead and take a look at things. I just love the way this map looks when you get really up close to it. So let's take a look at the starting positions here. So this map is, of course, Langra. And in the northern position here, we do have ProPipe spawning in as ProPipe Blitz, his Blitzkrieg commander, and I'm going to swap to his point of view right off the bat here just so we can look at his abilities. You can see he does have infantry pillage, flares, stormtroopers, rocket barrage, and heavy armor support. And by the way, he has a lot of pile spamming type abilities out there right now, but it does not look like he's doing a pile spam build order. He just has the second squad of pioneers coming out right now, grabbing this fuel point, his first squad finishing on Wehrmacht quarters, and that's it. So likely he's just going to be going into more of a Volks kind of focused early game. Meanwhile, on the southern side of this map, let me swap on over to AFK Ninja's point of view. He is, of course, playing as his armor commander, and AFK Ninja has armor bounty. He's got HVAP rounds, self-repair, Sherman Calliope, and the Pershing. And pretty much, he's just doing the exact same thing. He's just capping very casually, just kind of getting the stuff right next to his base. You'll notice that he does have these nice-looking elite engineers coming out right now, which is why he was a little bit slower getting the rest of his caps going on there. These guys do come with two Browning automatic rifles, and they can throw hand grenades. Really, really awesome unit there. I believe that is drop only. Meanwhile, up top here, ProPipe is just kind of capping whatever he wants. Just, again, conservative play by both people, just kind of grabbing the stuff right outside of their bases. Nothing too fancy going on here. A lot of times players will stab outward and try to grab these munitions points or the strategic point here or something deeper into their opponent's territory early on, but none of that today. Meanwhile, it looks like these elite engineers just kind of continuing their caps on and on and on. And we have the first rifleman squad out on the field for AFK Ninja. So it looks like his riflemen, by the way, do have the 30% sight range, 9% accuracy, and ooh, the free sticky bombs. I really love the free sticky bomb research. And check this out. Notice what AFK Ninja is doing here. He is cap walking right now, which is a little trick that you can do if you queue up your waypoints just perfectly. You can see that one member of this squad continued walking all the way over to this strategic point here, meaning as soon as he finishes capping this point, the squad is already here, and he can just chain cap back to back like that. That is a pretty brutal little trick right there. I'm sure that's technically a bug, but it's pretty hard to pull off, actually. In case you're curious about that, by the way, I remember reading a nice article by Nuclear Sensei on the KohoGameReplays.org forums all about capwalking a while back, so check that out. Meanwhile, over here on the left, we do have the elite engineers just kind of capping away. These guys are pretty good at standing on their own. If you want to have some passive-aggressive warfare, they can do a great job at just kind of fighting off stuff. It looks like the riflemen here have grabbed hold of this building. Always a key building there, but just kind of a little bit of light fighting. Maybe we have our first skirmish of the game coming up right now. Riflemen moving on in, exchanging some fire with these Volksrangers. Riflemen, unfortunately, are a little bit exposed here. You can see they have completely exposed armor because they're standing in the street. Now they're going back to just kind of a medium cover. Just next to them, the riflemen are here. Perhaps having a nice flanking position, but it's hard to tell. We do have the Fatherland HMG team out right now for ProPipe, setting up nicely in the middle of the map right here. These guys are, of course, very dangerous. They have great range when they're in friendly territory. And you can see that these Volksrangers are grabbing this forward strategic point here. But, ooh, we've got a little bit of sneaky action going here. It looks like AFK Ninja pulling his riflemen and his engineers back completely around, having a beautiful-looking flank on this Fatherland HMG team, and really just focusing away at it here. Nice-looking flank there. Simultaneous attack happening over here on the left, as well as the elite engineers are coming in, putting a lot of pressure on the pioneers. It looks like this Fatherland HMG team has lost a single member, and these guys are just continuing to just move on in, doing a lot of damage. Fatherland HMG team is setting up, and it looks like AFK Ninja might just be able to split his troops perfectly and get them outside the range of that HMG team. Yes, he does. Neither squad gets caught as it sets up, and they continue to just pour focus fire right into that Fatherland HMG team, taking another casualty, continuing to retreat. Oh, and the Fatherland HMG team goes down. AFK Ninja off to a great start so far this game. Looks like he's really putting a lot of pressure on here. We do have the close combat Volks out right now, though, so not all hope is not lost for ProPipe, but his control over the center is severely challenged right now. We do have double rifleman squads in the middle here, And building close combat Vokes in a Fatherland HMG team like that really slows you down early game. You can see these Pioneers are coming in right now, being really, really brutally focused, though. And boom, there goes the Flamethrower Pioneer right there. So a second squad lost right away, early game here by ProPipe. You can see the Elite Engineers continuing to provide fire here with those Browning Automatic Rifles. And close combat Vokes now moving in. Four members left in this squad. Getting in nice and intimate here with these Riflemen. Probably going to do some serious damage there. But there is a lot of support fire helping these guys out. Down to three members right now. It looks like the Elite Engineers right now firing right into these close combat Vokes. Elite Engineers have got nice green cover. Oh, throwing a hand grenade even. Hand grenade goes off and it looks like kills two models of that squad. A single close combat Vokes now returning home. Brand new Fatherland HMG team already on the field right now for ProPipe. And woo, that might just have been in time there, but a lot of serious losses right there for ProPipe. I'm going to take a look here at ProPipe's point of view and just keep track of his army right now. It looks like he does have the one machine gun team, very, very wounded close combat Vokes, and then just the regular Vokes and a single Pioneer right there. Where meanwhile, let me take a look around here at AFK Ninja. It looks like AFK Ninja does have four Rifleman squads and two Engineers. He is off to a beautiful start here. I think ProPipe might be giving up a little bit early here, honestly. It is game two. So it looks like he's probably going to keep on playing for at least a little bit here, but that was definitely a lot of heavy losses here. But really, anybody else I would expect to keep on playing, but perhaps he's aware that a player of AFK Ninja's caliber is not going to let him come back from those early game losses there. A little bit more kind of focused firing going on over here on the right. You can see that the Browning Automatic Rifle upgrades are there. AFK Ninja, oh, completely taking out that Pioneer squad. AFK Ninja just wanting to put as much early pressure as he can. Going for fast Brownings is obviously a great idea. And now we have another beautiful looking flank style action coming in right now. And he's moving on out right now, putting some pressure on this Fatherland HMG team. He's going to have to back off. And oh, he's just going to completely envelop these close combat Vokes in the center from the looks of it here. Just going to have to stay away from that Fatherland HMG team a little bit. Again, positional cover definitely in favor of the Rifleman. Browning Automatic Rifle Fire just kind of spraying into these close combat Vokes. Close combat Vokes taking tons of casualties right now. Three members left, two members left, taking so much stuff. Oh, and it looks like ProPipe saying, he doesn't necessarily feel like being stubborn at all. Perhaps he is giving up a GG, and it looks like he has. So quick, really, really, really quick game there. Less than 7 minute game for game two there. So I don't know. I think that was sort of a demoralizing victory there. I think AFK Ninja managed to just kind of beat his opponent psychologically just with all the early game losses. It looks like ProPipe got completely flustered there and just kind of gave up. So man, lightning fast game there. Gotta be moving on to game three. So stay tuned.